This is my desktop CNC. Pretty cool, right? Well, there's one annoying problem with it. Every time I need to swap out the tool, I go through this circus act, unscrewing electronics, detaching cables, removing plates. It's a nightmare, and honestly, it gets so annoying that I end up avoiding the machine altogether. But before we get into the redesign, here's a bit of backstory on the machine. This CNC was built nearly a decade ago, just for fun. No real purpose, no electronics, barely functional. It sat in storage at my parents' place for years until I decided to revive it. I rebuilt it from scratch using an Arduino loaded with GRBL, new drivers, I redesigned and 3D printed the tool holder and the entire case, I wired it up, and since I had a 5-watt diode laser lying around, like every normal household does, I decided to use that as the main tool. But during the design, I got a bit carried away and didn't think ahead, so changing out the tool, even though I don't have any other tools just yet for the machine, it's a tedious process. The laser control board is mounted on the same tool holder, blocking the screws that hold the laser. And the laser is blocking the screws for the backplate. Also, to add an extra layer of stupidity, the screws that hold the tool in place are mounted on the back of the backplate. So changing tools meant a full teardown every time. Time for a smarter solution, and thank god I had the old design file saved so I don't have to do the measurements all again. I modified the old design by adding 4 screws accessible from the front, chosen specifically for their simplicity and easy access. No more backplate removal. I also decided to add a 3-pin automotive connector for a quick detachment, because it's easy to add and I don't have to manually unscrew the cables every time I have to do a tool change. With this new design ready, I drilled and tapped the backplate. I'm fairly certain it's not the best idea to tap a 3mm thick sheet of aluminium and mount a tool to it, but if it won't hold, I will add riveted nuts to it. For the print, I used Polylite PETG from Polymaker. The only adjustment I had to make after the print finished was to drill the hole for the laser's board and add the threaded insert. The insert I used is for injection molds and not 3D prints, but this is not a load-bearing part, so it won't really matter. And honestly, it was a good excuse to use them, because I bought too many before realizing they weren't the right kind. To glue the connector in place, I used a 2-component epoxy adhesive, since it seemed like a good choice given that the connector shape wasn't flush with the tool mount. After this, putting it together was really straightforward. The following day, once the epoxy had fully cured, I proceeded with the final assembly steps. The first thing I did was to remove the temporary zip tie that had been holding the connector in place during gluing. Next, I carefully screwed the laser module back into its designated position. I also mounted the PCB, which is secured with a small screw into place, and to improve cable management and ensure a cleaner fit, I shortened the connector cables before attaching them to the board. With those preparations done, I moved on to installing the tool mount onto the CNC itself. This part was relatively straightforward. I attached the newly tapped backplate and then fastened the tool holder using the 4 easily accessible screws in the front. After securing the hardware, I trimmed and soldered the male connector onto the CNC's wiring harness. Once everything was mounted and the connectors were joined, the hardware setup was finally complete. I used this 35-watt large fish tank compressor for air assist, and attached it to the nozzle on the laser that I made a while ago. During the cutting process, air assist helps by blowing away smoke and debris, resulting in a cleaner cut and protecting the laser's lens. After I was finished, to test it out, I've chosen to create an engraving of the channel's logo on a small piece of wood. To create this engraving, I chose to use LaserGRBL because it's easy to use, and as an added bonus, it is an open source software. By a miracle, I managed to nail the laser settings on the first try, which has never happened to me before. From a forgotten hobby build to a reliable desktop tool, this CNC has come a long way. And now that I have this new mounting design, I've started working on new tools for the machine. I already have some new ideas, for example, a custom engraving tool that I've been working on lately. If you like this transformation, drop a like and let me know what project you've revived lately. See you next time!